The question, what are bad habits to avoid when learning the electric guitar? Quite a few. Here's some I can remember off the top of my head. Spider fingers. When holding the chords, ensure your fingers are as close to 90 degrees angle as possible. Don't flatten them onto the fretboard unless you're doing barring slash bridging. Muting. Learn to mute with your strumming hand palm as well as your fingers. Avoiding bar chords in favor of power chords. Yes, they're tiring. Yes, they're not as rock sounding as power chords. But you sometimes need that full sound of a bar chord rather than your three-fingered power chord. Practice, 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 goes without saying. Don't slack off on this, especially mastering those scales. Floyd Rose versus fixed bridge. If you're a beginner, save yourself a lot of headaches and frustration and start on a fixed bridge or tremolo only. Floyd Rose bridges may be cool and all, but they're a serious pain in the posterior. Even after 20 years, I still avoid Floyd Rose guitars as I don't think they're worth the hassle for my playstyle. But to each their own. Overplaying, you may think you're the coolest kid on the block since you're on electric guitar. But please, play your parts and do your fill-ins tastefully. You don't have to keep jamming throughout every damn song. Having said that, I still do this, so I know your feel, bro. But seriously, less is more, and your band members will appreciate it. No capo, you are not in the mafia. Leave the capo at home, and learn to play bar chords, see number 3. No excuse, especially since e-guitars are usually on 0.10 gauge or lower. Oh yes, and this too. Using too high a gauge on your strings. The beauty of an electric guitar is that you can modulate and control your sound on the pickups, preamp effects, amps, etc. Therefore, in my opinion, finesse is far more important than heavy-handedness in playing, and a lighter gauge helps you achieve that better. Pressing down too hard on a note because you're used to a heavier gauge will cause problems in your sound in the long run. Hope that helps. Keep on rocking.